the worst hit villages during the cyclone winter. All the houses were gone, including my house. And now we are still living in tents and Mexico, waiting for our materials from the government.
You haven't received your building material yet?
Yeah.
Have you registered under the...
Yes, we've home? Registered from under the Help for Home. It comes to the standards we used to have before, but finding it very hard. Finding it very hard to do. Cabot seedlings coming from non-government organizations, but not enough. We needed some more seedlings like watermelon. They are very fast crops that can get us back on track.
You got four children. Felipe, can you just tell me the situation when the cyclone came? What happened?
Actually, I have seven children. Three children back in the village. I have four children with us. That time was very hard. It was a very hard time for us finding places to go, get sheltered, because our house was blown away, and we sheltered in another house, and that house too was blown away, and we got shelter underneath a floor of a house for the duration of the cyclone until the cyclone was gone. And then we tried to put together a house so they could stay there.
Felipe, you have small children. They must be looking up to you during the cyclone for you to provide security and safety for them.
Yes.
What was going in your mind during the time to protect your children?
I'm an ex-military personnel. So I did everything right. No one of them was injured. I had a small baby, which was my daughter's baby with us. 2 months old baby with us. And I moved them safely and found out this place to shelter in during the cyclone. No one was injured, there were no scratches on the kids, including me.
Is there any, you are here, despite all the problems and issues you face, but you are here with your family to attend the Constitution Day. What made you come today and be part of this?